Hi children, today we are going to learn 6th class, 3rd chapter, playing with numbers. In that, exercise number 3.4. In this exercise, we are going to learn that how to find out HCF, highest common factor. So already we know about what is HCF. And we also know what is the meaning of a factor and common factor. This, I already done a video about the HCF and LCF. I hope you watch that video. If not, I'll keep that link in the description. You watch once again. So here we are going to find out the HCF in the two methods. One is by the fine factorization method. The other one is by long division method. So in the both the methods, we get the same answers in every problem. Either you do the problem in prime factorization method or else in long division method. Even you will get a same answer. So without wasting time, let us take the problems from the exercise 3.4 and we'll solve one by one in the both the methods accordingly the question. Okay. So here the first bit. There are four questions are given, four internal questions in this first bit. The first one, see that what he asked to find. Find the HCF of the following numbers by fine factorization method and continued division method. So both also will do it. First of all, let us take the question here. The question is 18, 27, 36. We have to find out the HCF of these three numbers by using two methods. The first method is, let us do it, prime factorization method. Prime factorization method. By using this method, let us see how to solve the problem. So, let us take 18 first. 18, we have to factorize by only prime numbers. You have to take only prime numbers here. 2, 9 are 18, and 3, 3 are 9, and it is finished now. Again 3 will possible only in 3 table, that's not required. So here let's go for 18, we can write as 2 into 3 into 3. Yes. So again we solve the other problems also. Just like other numbers will take it and do it. See. Here let us take 27. 27 possible in 3 table. 3 9s are 27. Again 3 3s are 9. Okay. It is also completed. Okay. Then how about you continue this 3 1s are 3. Here also 3 1s are 3. No problem. Then let us take 36. 36 is possible first, it is possible in 2 table. 2 18s are 36. 2 9s are 18. 3 3s are 9. And 3 1s are 3. As we have completed. So, see that this 18 we can write like 1 into. Okay, we will start from here. 2 into 3 into 3. Next, 27. 27 is the product of the prime factors, that is 1 into 3 into 3 into 3. Then this 36 is equal to 1 into then 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. So where?
So whenever you find the HCF, remember the highest common factors. The highest common factors. We have to choose the common factors here. What are the common factors? Let us see. So here the common factors for all these three numbers. Here one is the common factor for every number. You remember one is the common factor for every number. Then here 2 is the common factor for only 18 and 36. It is not for 27. So leave it. Then yes, 3 is a common factor. See,
3 is a common factor for every number, and here also there is a 3 is a common factor for every number. Hence, the HCF of 18, 27, 36 is the product of these common factors. 1 into 3 into 3, that is 9. So the HCF of this 18, 27, 36, by 5 factorization we get 9. I hope you understood. Now the next, the same problem will do it by continued division method. He also asked you continued division method. Continued division method. So how to do it in continued division method? This is also very important. See, these are the three numbers I have given. From this, you take any two numbers. First, you take the largest number as a dividend, that is 36. Yes. Then you take any one of this number as a divisor here. So I'm gonna take here 18 as a divisor. So one smallest number, one largest number I took. But that is your choice. You can take any numbers. Okay. First, you take the largest number. See, 18. 2's are 36. It's divisible completely. So it is completed. Then here, HCF of 18, 36 is 18. But again, one more 27 is left. No, this also we have to do it. But then now, the HCF of 18, 27 is, we have to continue this again. 27 here, 18. 18 ones are 18. Because 18 twos are 36 is not possible. So we take this. Okay. Then here, 7 minus 8, it's not possible. So it is 17 minus 8. 17 minus 8, that is 9. 1 minus 1 is 0. So now, this is the remainder you got. So in the continuous division method, the remainder become a divisor, and the first divisor become a dividend. So here, now we have to continue the same process again. 9 twos are 18. This 18 we took from the first divisor. Until you get the remainder 0, you have to follow this process. Now, the last divisor become a HCF. Here, now, the HCF of this 18, 27, 36 is 9. See here, the HCF of these three numbers, by using prime factorization method, we got 9. And also the continued division method, we got the HCF as a 9. In the sense, in the both the methods, in prime factorization method as well as in the long division method also, continued division method or long division method, both are same. In the both methods we get the same answer always. So let us take one more question and we'll try to solve this problem. Okay. Here there are four questions I already told you. So I'm not going to be doing 4 out of 4 questions. I'll do it 2 questions here. The remaining 2 questions I will give you as a work. I hope you can do that. But you have to listen here very carefully what I am doing here. Second question, that 106, 159, 265. So let us see what is the HCF of these 3 numbers by using these 2 methods. First of all, prime factorization method. We have to take 106 here. It's possibly 2 table. 2 5s are 10, 2 3s are 6. Now, here 53. As we know that 53 is a prime number. The prime number will not appear in any table. So, 53 will become only in the 53 table only. 53 ones are 53. It is completed. Now, let us take it. 159. 159. 10, 15. Yes, it's possible in 3 table. 3 5 is a 15, 3 3 is a 9. Again, 53 you got. This 53 is a prime number. Prime number will only appear in the prime number. Next, 265. Yes, here 265, 8 plus. Here 8 plus 5, that is 13. Okay, let us see if it is possible in 5 table. 5 5 is a 25, 5 3 is a 15. Again, you got 53, 53 possible only in the 53 table. So, here we can write now the front factors, the product of front factors of 106, that is 1 into 2 into 53. The front factors of 159, that is 1 into 3 into 53. You see that 1 is a common factor for every number. So 5, that means 265 is equal to 1 into 5 into 53. Now you can easily identify what are the common factors. The common factors are 53 and 1. The product of common factors are not, therefore the HCM, HCF of 106, 159, 265 is the product of these common factors. Product of the common factors. The product of the common factors will give us HCF. The product of the common factor and non-common factors will give us LCM. Okay. Now 1 into 53 is 53. That means this 53 is the HCF of these three given numbers. Now let us also do it in the continuous division method. First of all, let us choose one greatest number here, that is 265, and let us take one of the number, let us take one smallest number, that is 106. And we do the division here. 106 twos are 2, 6 are 12, 1 carry. 2 zeros are 0, 1, that is 1, and 2 ones are 2, as it possible 2 times. So let us subtract here. 5 minus 2 is 3, 6 minus 1 is 5, and here 2 minus 2 is 0. Now this remainder become a divisor. The first divisor become a dividend in this continuous division method. Now 53 twos are 106. We got the 0 here. That means the HCF of these two numbers is 53. But we have to continue. There is a one more number also here. So let us take, that is 159. We have to divide by the last divisor by the 53. Now let us continue. 53 3s are 159. It's also you got a 0. Therefore, the last divisor you got as a 53. Therefore, the HCF of this 106, 159, 265 is 53. So this is a long division method and this is by prime factorization method. Okay. In the prime factorization method, we can also find out the LCM. To find out the LCM, how to do it, we'll learn in the next exercise. But also I'll tell you a hint here. To find out the HCF, what we have done? The product of common factors we have done here. To find out the LCM here, product of the common factors into this non-common factors also. This also will multiply. 2 into 5, 2 into 3 into 5 into 53 into 1 we have to do it. So that we get LCM. So that we will learn in the next exercise. Don't worry. So these are the two problems I have done here. The remaining two problems of this exercise is your work. So the two more problems from this exercise you need to do it. So that questions also I will write here. So just copy the questions. The third question we have to do it. That is 10, 35, 40. Find out the HCF in the both the methods and also 32, 64, 96, 128. These two questions you do and find out the HCF in the both the methods. Then let's go for second question solution. Here let me read the second question. Find the largest number
which is a factor of each of the numbers 504, 792 and 1080. So what's the largest number we need to find out? Largest factor. So the given number, okay, the given numbers are, the given numbers are here 504, 792, 1080. We have to find out the largest number. The largest number, which is a factor of this. To find out the largest number of these numbers, we have to find out the HCF. Then let us find out the HCF of these three numbers. We have to find out the HCF of these three numbers. Largest number in the sense, here itself we have to understand. Okay. Here we have the HCF of this number. I'll go for a division method. I'll go for a continued division method. Also, you can also go for prime factorization method, division method. So, which method is very comfortable for you, you can go for that method. Okay, I can go for the division method, that is 1080, I'll divide by 504 here. Simple. So, here 504, yes, 504. 504 twos are, 2 fours are 8, 2 zeros are 0, 2 fives are 10. Yes, here 1080 minus 1008, here 10 minus 8 is 2, here it will be 7 minus 0 is 7, 10 minus 10 is 0. Then we have to continue again this 504. This remainder become a divisor and this first divisor become a dividend. So let us see how many it is possible like. Okay, then 72, let us take 7s are 72 into 7s are, let us say 7 2s are 14, 1 carry 7 7s are 49 plus 150, yes, exactly we get 7 times. So 72 7s are, as we are seeing, 504 we got, the remainder is 0. Now the HCF of these two numbers 504 and 1080 is 72, but we have to consider the other number also. So let us take the other number, that is, and we will continue 792, and we have to take the last divisor, that is 72, and let us continue that. Okay, so here 72 ones are 72, it's possible. Let's see here, 9 minus 2 is 7, 7 minus 7 is 0, and this 2 I have to bring down, so here 72 is left. Yes, now see that this 72 and the last, the 72 is the remainder, the last divisor is also 72, 72 ones are 72, here we got 0. So the last divisor is 72, therefore HCF, that means here we did not ask the HCF, they asked the highest, the largest number, therefore the largest number which is a factor of, which is, okay, the largest number is 72, which is a factor of, which is a factor of 504, 792 and 1080. So this is the 72 is a highest factor which divides these all numbers without leaving remainder. That means in the 72 table we can find the 504, in the 72 table we can find out the 792, in 72 table we will also get 1080. So this is the highest factor which divides these numbers exactly without leaving remainder. So that is called HCF. So I hope you understood this. Now let me go for third question. Yes, this is also we need to find out the HCF.
The length, comma, breadth and height of the rooms 12 centimeters, 12 meters, comma, 15 meters and 18 meters are respectively. Determine the length of the largest stick
can we measure these all dimensions of the room exact number of times?
Yes. The given measurements are given here. The measurements are length of the room, length of the room is equal to 12 meters, and here breadth of the room equal to 15 meters, and height of the room 18 meters.
The largest stick, you take your one largest stick and measure these all dimensions, length, breadth, height, so that the stick can be measured this completely without leaving a little space also. So you just think that which number will divide completely these three numbers, that is called the largest number, that is called a HCF. Here we need to find out. See, normally I can say three table we can find out these all numbers in 3 4s are 3 5s are 3 6s are. Yes, the length of the longest stick is 3 meters. If 3 meter stick, if you take and measure this length, breadth, height of this room, it divides exactly, it covers some number of times. I hope you understand. So what we need to do it now, here we need to find out the HCF. So HCF, you can go for the prime factorization method or long division method. So in this case, let me go for prime factorization method or long division method, no problem. I'll go for long division method. Long division method. So I'll take here 18, and the smallest number I'll take 12. 12 ones are 12. The remainder is 6 here. The remainder become a divisor, and first divisor become a dividend. We have to continue again. 6 twos are 12. Here we got the 0. So the HCF of this 12 and 18 is 6. But we have to continue with one more number, that is a 15 here again. 15. And we have to take the last two divisor, that is 6. Okay. 6 twos are 12, 3 left, and this is a remainder. Remainder become a divisor, and first divisor become a dividend. 3 2s are 6, it is completed now. As this is the HCF, therefore the largest stick which can measure this room, that is 3 meters. See what you asked? Find out the here. Find out the longest stick can be measured these 3 dimensions. The largest stick is 3 meters. Therefore, the length of longest stick can measure, stick is 3 meters, can measure these dimensions exactly, room dimensions, given room dimensions. Given room dimensions exactly. So this is what I hope you understood here. Let us go for next question. Now let us solve it. The next question, the question number 4. See that already we know the meaning of coframes. Are relative frames. Coframes are relative frames. So coframes are relative frames in sim. The numbers which have only one as a common factor, they are known as a coframes or relative frames. So we know that every number has one as a common factor. See that HCF of coframes 4 and 15 was found as the following factorization. So the four factors of 4, they have given 2 into 2. Then the 15 they have given as a 3 into 5, and is also given here 4 and 15 are coframes. 4 and 15 are said as a coframes. So since there is no common factor here, there is no common factor in the sense. So here 2 and 2, here 3 and 5. For this, there is no common factor for 4 and 15. Yes. Here 4 and 15 having two different common factors. As the HCF of 4 and 15 is at 0. Then the HCF of these numbers is 0 itself.
Will you agree with that? Can you say the HCF of 4 and 15 cofrans is 0? The HCF of 4 and 15 is 0? No. Therefore, here, where what is the meaning of cofrans? You know, the numbers which has only one common factor. The numbers which has only one has a common factor, those numbers are known as a known as a cofrans. So as a given that 4 and 15 are cofrans, so here 4 and 15 having one as a common factor, so 4 and 15 having one as a common factor, so 4 and 15 have one as a common factor. So therefore, the HCF of 4 and 15 is not 0. So the HCF of 4 and 15 is not 0. Here I can give the conclusion at last. Therefore, the HCF of 4 and 15 is 1. And also you can mention that the HCF of cofrans always 1. Remember, always 1. The HCF of cofrans always 1. Here note, the HCF of cofrans are always 1. This you need to remember. Or not, you can see that prime factorization of 4, we can write 2, 2, 1. Here, prime factorization of 15, 3, 5 is a 15 and 5 is a 5. So, 4 can be written as 1 into 2 into 2 and 15 we can write as a 1 into 5 into 3. Here, we have 1 as a common factor. So, therefore, HCF of 4 and 15 is 1. So here, in this way also you can do it. You can write this complete information or not. Here by using prime factorization method you do it. Here you will get 1 as a common factor. So remaining all factors are different. So HCF of 4 and 15 is 1. You can write this answer or not. You can write complete this information also. This more clearly we have given everything. Here directly we have done this problem actually. Here, what they have done, here into 1 and into 1 they did not write. If they write, 1 is a common factor for every number. So, if you would have written the 1, we get HCF as a 1. But he did not write that. This is what they have done, the mistake. That means to check your knowledge, they have not written there. But we have to remember, 1 is a factor for every number. So, here we get 1 as a HCF of cofrans. And you always remember one thing, the HCF of cofrans are this. 1. The HCF of cofrans is always 1. Now, next, question number 5. Question number 5 solution.
What is the capacity of largest vessel which can empty the oil from 3 vessels containing 32 liters, 24 liters, and 48 liters. Okay, so here they asked LCM for this. Okay, what is the capacity of largest vessel? So there are 3 vessel systems. You know, there are 3 vessels here which contains oil. Okay, which contains oil here, 3 vessels. Okay, 3 vessels are there. This vessels continues
32 liters, and this vessel having 24 liters of oil, and this vessel also having 48 liters of oil. So find out a largest vessel. Find out the largest vessel which can cover these three vessels oil. Okay, find out the largest vessel here. So which can, with that we can empty these three oil vessels actually. If you pour these three vessels oil in this largest vessel, this should be filled up. That means that largest vessel should be covers completely without any gap. It should be cover this oil. That means if you pour these three vessels oil in this, it should be filled up completely. So we have to find out what is the capacity of this largest vessel. It has 32 liters of capacity. This vessel has 22 liters of capacity, and this vessel has 48 liters of capacity. Then what is the largest vessel capacity? This capacity we need to find out. So for this we need to find out the LCM actually. So the capacity of three vessels. The capacity of three vessels equal to 32 liters comma 24 liters comma 48 liters. For this we need to find out the LCM. We have to find out the LCM. So let us go for the LCM in the division method. I'll go for this is division method. Division method. So we know how to do the division method. 32 comma 24 comma 48. So here you have to take the number which is divides these numbers. I'll go for 2 table. 2 16 the 32, 2 12 are 24, 2 24 are 48. Next, these numbers also able to divide by 2 again. 2 8 are 16, 2 6 are 12, yes, 2 12 are 24. Again, these are possible again in the 2 table. 2 4 are 8, 2 3 are 6, 2 4 are, sorry, 2 6 are 12. Again, these 2 are possible in the 3 table, or not, this 2 is possible in the 2 table. You can go for 2, 2 2 is a 4, 3 is not possible in 3 tables. So in 2 table 3 is not possible, so we write the 3 as it is. In 2 table 6 will comes 3 times. Now again it is possible in the 3 time, 3 table. In 3 table 2 don't comes, it won't come, so you write same 3 1s are 3 and 3 1s are 3. So you can enough here, therefore LCM equal to, you get here the product of this 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 2, 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 1 2, yes, into 1 into 1. If you do it or don't do, you get the same answer only. Let us multiply this. 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8, 8 to the 16, 16 3 is a 48, 48 to the 96. So 96 liters. Okay, 96 liters. So this is the capacity of largest vessel which can empty these three vessels. Therefore the capacity of largest vessel equal to, therefore, yes, the capacity of largest vessel equal to 96 liters, which can empty these three tins, okay, completely. That means the 32 liters, if you pour it, 36 liters of vessel, if you pour three times, this will be 96 liters. If you pour three times this, it will be completely filled. Or that you take this 24 liters, okay, 24 liters, if you pour four times, it will be filled up with 96. 24 4 is 96. 32 3 is 96. And 48 2 is 96. That means if you pour this vessel 2 times, it will be filled. This vessel if you pour 4 times, it will be filled. And if this vessel if you pour
3 times it will be filled. That means this is the largest vessel which can empty this 3 given vessels. I hope you understood this problem also. With this exercise is got completed. I hope you understood well. Practice this HCF problems properly. In the next exercise I will explain you how to find out the LCM. Thank you for watching video. Thank you.